Asian Paints profit rose for the second straight quarter in line with analyst estimates. Agam Bakhlid standing by with the fine print of the numbers. Agam, good morning.
Good morning, Neeraja. Let's start off with the fact that Asian Paints, along with a lot of the other consumption companies, was working on a low base. That said, when it comes to its top line, it's come up with a number of around 10%, 10.5% growth. And this is in terms of net sales. And that number is below Bloomberg consensus expectations. The surprise here, however, is an expansion in your operating margins coming in at around 20.9%, whereas our expectation was around 19.5%. And because of this, we have seen profits grow as much as 19% on a year-on-year basis. Now, everyone was watching out for the impact of crude oil because we have seen a sequential uptick, that's a given. But we've also seen a year-on-year uptick. And because of that, we have seen raw materials costs move up by as much as 13.6%. And raw material costs taken as a ratio to revenues, that ratio now stands at 50% as against 44% year-on-year. So there has been a substantial uptick, and that is very, very evident in the raw materials costs. I think the reason why we are looking at expansion margins because of their focus on the premium segment, which of course commands higher margins. And other than that, we're also looking at other expenses, which were down as much as 6.5%. So on the whole, a mixed quarter, I would say. Weakness does come in with respect to revenues, and they have suggested double-digit revenues, which means it will be likely around 10-11%. But no more than that. I think what is going to be crucial is how they see demand pick up as we move in and what crude can do for their input costs.
Agam, just throwing this out of the dark at you, but yesterday when I was speaking to Yash, he mentioned that Kansai and Aerol Act 2 had a mixed bag of numbers, though no disappointments on the volume front, but a mixed bag nevertheless. Seems like paint companies are setting a bit of a trend.
Yes, Neeraj. And in fact, when it comes to Kansai and Aerol Act, what's really come out, there is the impact of input costs. And that's the reason why their margins took a hit. Surprisingly, we were also expecting a contraction in, your margins for Asian Paints, but that has not come to be. So there is a little bit of a contrast there. But we also have to remember that Kansai and Aerol Act, is focused in industrial paints. And so their margins picture, because of the product mix, will be different from Asian Paints, which looks at the premium segment. So to a certain extent, there is that dichotomy. But other than that, when it comes to your volumes, again, all will be determined by how they do in this particular quarter.